May I have the vegetable spring roll and Dungeons crab cake?
What do you think is going to happen in 15 years for you, in 10 years? Where do you see yourself?
Best case, in a cemetery.
Really?
Not in a cemetery. Sprinkled in ashes, smoked up by my homies. That's the worst case. Best case, multi-millionaire, owning all of this shit, you know what I'm saying? Because anywhere else, if I was white, I would have been like John Wayne. You know what I'm saying? Somebody who pulled themselves up from their bootstraps, from poverty, from welfare. Now I'm kissing Janet Jackson, getting movies. I feel like a tragic hero in a Shakespeare play. You know what I'm saying?
Oh yeah. Round, I get around.
I'm not really that educated, you know, and I'm not really a religious person, but I believe that God wants me to do something, and it has to do with thug life. You know, I want there to be a life for the street element instead of we always getting shut out, you know, instead of defenseless having power.
Cause shorty wanna be a thug, said he wanna be, what said he wanna be, what said he wanna be, shorty's gonna be.
Well, my mother was a woman, a black woman, a single mother, raising two kids on her own. So she was dark skinned, had short hair, got no love from nobody except a group called the Black Panthers. So that's why she was a Black Panther.
Cause I don't consider myself to be straight, you know, militant. You know what I'm saying? I'm a thug. I'm a thug. And my definition of thug comes from half of the street element, just straight street hustlers, and half of the Panthers element, half of the independence movement. I'm saying we want self-determination, and we want to do it by self-defense and by any means necessary. That came from my family, and that's what thug life is, you know, it's a mixture.
Machiavellian is Illuminati, all through your body.
How do people treat you differently, the people that you grew up with? Now that you're famous,
they believe in the machine, not Tupac no more. They don't even know me no more. They just know about the machine.
You mean the press machine?
Yeah.
Is that painful for you?
Mm-hmm. Everybody wants to use me. Everybody, from this level to the street level. So I'm used on every level. I have no friends. I have no resting place. I never sleep. I can never close my eyes. It's horrible. Can you imagine what it's like for you to be who I am, who I was, and for them to say that I raped a woman, and for the whole world to actually be entertaining the thought that you raped a woman? That's hell.
You're feeling sort of ripped off by the press.
I am being ripped off because I've never lied to the press. Just as much truth I bring to my work, a journalist should bring that much truth to their work. Why do I have honor and you guys don't have honor? I'm not a journalist, I'm a thug.
Do you think you'll prevail in court?
I have to see. I believe in God. Whatever's supposed to happen is supposed to happen. But I cannot live in a jail cell. And that's why I don't rob people and stick up people. But for you to put me there and I didn't do it, I wouldn't go that route. I would die in jail. And that's what they want. They want me to go through all of that and then come out. But I'm already dead. No creativity. I'm finished. There's a machine that I have nothing to do with. It's called the Tupac machine. And the media in this country have just fueled it and made me a monster. The people just, they say I'm a criminal. They say I spit hateful, vicious, violent lyrics. You know, it's like, I'm ready to be the bad guy. I'm already, they gave me that job. I'm ready to have it.
When Dan Quayle was suggesting that your album should be pulled off the racks and stuff like that, in a way, that was probably the best publicity you could have gotten for your album.
I don't see that as being the best publicity you could have gotten. Who wants the vice president of the country that you live in, country that you are ready to defend, to say that your music is not this, without him even listening to your album, without him even have known you or to meet you, for him to just make that? And she said,
"You were hurt by that."
I was crushed. Crushed.
Did you have some great respect for Dan Quayle?
No, I just had respect for government. A little bit of respect for government to say, you know, how could you do that? You know what I'm saying?
Do you see yourself as a role model?
No, I see myself as real. Like, I mean, if I was the president, I'd have a responsibility because people put me there. Nobody put me here. They just buy my records. They wouldn't buy my records if my records wasn't good. I'm being who I am in the record.
Back in elementary, I thrived on misery. Left me alone, I grew up amongst a dying breed. Inside my mind, couldn't find a place to rest until I got that thug like tatted on my chest.
Anything that's giving you comfort in, you know, these days?
Recently, Madonna came to me. Madonna, I met Madonna. She,
what was that like? Tell me about
she
that.
She told me they treat you like the Antichrist, and I've been through that before, and I just want to be a friend.
No. I lost so many pigs and shed so many tears.
Now that I'm struggling in this business by any means, label me greedy, getting green, but seldom seen. Take me away from all the pressure and all the pain. Show me some happiness again.